job site, one of the largest industrial buildings in New England. The rooftop, 13 acres and covered end to end with hundreds of rows of delicate solar panels. The job, installing three massive HVAC units in the middle of that roof, each the size of a small car and weighing over 2,200 pounds. There's no crane on earth that could lift equipment that size more than 30 feet and then to the middle of the roof hundreds of feet away. But Donovan Sheet Metal got the job done. We didn't use a crane at all. We used a massive helicopter. Enter the Sikorsky S61 helicopter from CHI Aviation. It's big, it's bad, and it's powerful. At 17 feet tall and over 58 feet long with a rotor diameter of 62 feet, this 12,000-pound behemoth has a lifting capacity of over 4 tons and a cabin big enough to carry 30 passengers. Today's crew of four, pilot Doug Sapersky, co-pilot Jim Wilkerson, and crew members Josh Regan and Stu Edwards, flew in from Ohio, dodging storms the whole way to help DSM put the nearly 7,000 pounds of finishing touches on this job. Doug and Jim will lift off and turn around to meet the ground crew at the staging area next to the 30-foot tall building. They'll hover 100 feet above the unit while the ground crew attaches the massive hoisting cable. Then the helicopter will carry the unit to the crew on the roof to set it down. The first thing to do, hours before the helicopter even arrives on site, is to get the massive HVAC unit out of the building, onto the flatbed tractor trailer, and move to the staging area on the other side of the building. They're so large, they barely fit through the cargo doors of this massive facility. But Eddie Atwell offers some guidance from inside.
You side shift, right there.
And John Morris is able to back the first unit out the door, down the ramp, and onto the facility's lot, where he can turn around and prepare to load it onto the semi waiting outside. Eddie grabs the blocks and heads to the other side of the truck so he and Larry Donovan can help guide John as he maneuvers the unit up and into place.
How are you looking, Eddie? You all set?
Then they position the blocks to give the forklift enough clearance to set the unit down and back away. Then it's back inside to pick up the second HVAC unit and place it on the truck, leaving enough space to fit one more. Once John backs away, Larry climbs on top and starts tying the first two units down to the truck's bed with large nylon chokers to make sure they don't shift when the truck starts moving. Meanwhile, John is skillfully and carefully backing the third unit out through the facility's cargo door and down the ramp to the truck, where Larry and Eddie give him two more sets of eyes so he can place the unit down on the blocks, which they have positioned in the remaining space at the back of the flatbed. And with Unit 3 now secured, Larry starts the truck's engine and begins the three-quarter mile trip around the building, through the empty parking lot, it is a Sunday after all, and back to the staging area at the other end, where the helicopter will land to assist DSM with today's installation. Larry removes the caution tape while John shows up with the forklift. Then it's a matter of deciding where to place the three HVAC units that makes the most sense for the logistics of the lifting process, making sure they leave plenty of space for the helicopter to land.
Why don't we go one every other door, starting at this one.
Okay.
Go right here on the concrete. Facing all the same way.
They make their decision and move the forklift and truck into place so they can begin the process of removing the units from the truck and setting them where they need to be. Larry takes the first unit off the truck, backs up a bit, then because he's running out of room, he unintentionally but skillfully shows off his driving abilities as he performs a necessary 180 with the 2,200-pound HVAC unit on the lift's blades, so he can then back the unit up a few feet and set it down where it needs to be in front of cargo bay number 215. Then Eric Mayo, John, and Ronnie Toppy set the blocks beneath the corners of the unit as Larry begins to lower it, all the while making sure each block is properly placed so Larry can set the unit down and back the forklift out. John takes the second HVAC unit off the back of the truck and brings it around to its starting position. Then he heads right back to get unit 3. Up on the roof of this seemingly never-ending building, the hundreds of rows of delicate solar panels is just one reason this job is so difficult. Airlifting these three giant HVAC units is the only way to get them where they need to go, smack dab in the middle of the roof. Billy Welch applies a layer of foam tape, which will act as weather stripping to ensure a tight seal between the HVAC unit and its support structure. Snip, and it's ready. For safety's sake, nothing is left to chance, down to the smallest details.
Pick up everything, Larry?
Yeah, rocks, screws, bolts, any rocks, you know, bigger than like a marble.
The DSM crew does a sweep of the entire staging area for debris that could get kicked up by the massive squall from the arriving helicopter. And here it comes, flying in from Ohio, dodging storms the whole way, and apparently bringing some dark clouds with it. Hopefully the weather holds out, at least until his job is finished. It flies in over the building, then circles around, passing directly overhead, so the crew can get a good look at the entire job location, including the roof, the staging area, and the landing zone. They take a moment to assess the situation, then come in to set this massive machine down. The enormous rotary blades produce a wash of near hurricane force wind that blows 90-foot tall trees practically sideways. The crew has to brace themselves just to stay standing, but it's also a good indication that DSM has brought in the right machine to get the job done. The helicopter touches down and the crew members start exiting the craft as the intensity of the moment begins to subside and the engines gradually slow down. Once on the ground, pilots Doug and Jim unbuckle their safety harnesses and head out the door. And Larry Donovan and his team welcome them to the job site.
Did I land in the right place?
You're good.
I thought so.
This helicopter is an impressive machine. It dwarfs most other helicopters, and one look at the cockpit makes it abundantly clear that its pilots have to know what they're doing. And while we take a quick look at their helicopter to get a sense of just how big this flying crane is, Doug, Jim, and Stu have already begun the process of removing their gear for this job, with Larry right there to offer a helping hand. They get the last pieces out and arrange everything tightly together, then secure it so that it doesn't get blown around when the helicopter lifts off. Josh assembles the heavy-duty rigging they'll use to lift the massive machinery. It splits from one cable to four with grapples and a spreader bar to keep them separated and the tension even. In the meantime, Danny O'Brien brings over some of the cables that DSM's crew will attach to the HVAC units, with Larry making sure everything is done properly.
No rookie moves, backing out a half a turn, all right?
Once the DSM crew finishes up all of the prep work, they gather around alongside the HVAC units so that Doug can give them some important safety instructions.
So what we got hanging off this helicopter is a bunch of rigging goes down to four hooks. All right, so I'm gonna come up to a hover and bring those hooks over to you guys. And then you can bend down, pick up your choker, hang onto that hook from the back. Slap it in the choker, hold it up. Stu can see you guys are all hooked up. I'll start coming to tension. I'll pick it up and up I go. You're standing here and watching that thing fly over your head to the roof, you're standing in the wrong spot. All right, don't stand underneath these units at any point today. Land the unit up there. Once we land, we're going for the hook. We're looking here, not at the shackle. You guys all done this with the helicopter before?
Yes.
I'm good. So we don't have any new guys out here trying to take a selfie with the unit hanging right here by the face. The flip phone. That'll take that unit back to the parking lot. Other than that, those of you upstairs, you got your straps, you got to take your Skippy with you. And when you guys are briefed, It's okay.
Doug and Jim climb into the helicopter, make their way to the cockpit, and get into their seats, buckle themselves in, and start the engines.
Okay.
The process takes a few minutes because there are a lot of moving parts that they need to make sure are moving properly before even thinking about lifting off. The engine warms up, and the blades start turning and gaining speed. Doug looks out to make sure all is clear, and up they go, with Stu making sure the hoisting cable is all set. Doug and Jim slowly rise to about 120 feet off the ground. Then they carefully position the helicopter directly over the first HVAC unit, where John, Eddie, Eric, and Barry Fry each attach one of the four grapples as quickly as possible, making sure the cables aren't crossed, then hold them up to remove the slack. Stu gives the thumbs up, Doug increases the speed of the rotary blades, and the giant helicopter raises its load into the air. Then they haul the 2,200-pound unit hundreds of feet to the middle of the roof, where Larry, Danny, Billy, Ronnie, and Josh are waiting to help guide it down. Doug carefully lowers the unit to the crew below, while keeping a watchful eye on both the unit above them and the big rectangular hole they're standing next to. They each take a corner and literally push it into place. Josh tells Doug it's aligned properly, and he sets it down. Then each member of the crew finds the hook attached to his corresponding cable and releases it. Then they each take a step back and hold the hooks clear of the HVAC unit so that Doug and Jim can raise the helicopter and take off to go pick up unit number two. The process is much faster than you might expect, so the ground crew has to be ready when the helicopter returns. They grab hold of the grapples and attach them as quickly as possible, making sure all of the hooks are positioned properly and no cables are crossed. As soon as they're safely away from the giant HVAC unit, Doug and Jim lift it into the air and over to where the roof crew is waiting. It's the same process as before, and while speed is important, safety is of the essence. But the crew is experienced and work well together. So they quickly move the unit into place above the rigging, and Doug sets it down. Then they disconnect the hook so Doug and Jim can head back to Stu and the ground crew to pick up unit three. Two down, one to go. Things are going smoothly so far, but that's because this experienced team knows what they're doing. Back on the ground, each member of the crew grabs the right hook, attaches it, and holds it above the HVAC unit. Then they clear out so Doug and Jim can raise the unit into the air, over the roof, and down to the roof crew, who are ready and waiting at position number three. Doug slowly lowers it to them. This time, the unit comes down a few feet off target, but the members of the crew work together, pushing and pulling the heavy load while being mindful of the solar panels and the raised edge of the HVAC's rooftop support structure to eventually finesse the unit right into place. Stu makes sure it's properly aligned, then he gives Doug and Jim the signal to lower it the final few inches. The third time's a charm, but the job isn't done yet. As soon as the crew unhooks the unit, they quickly head over to the fourth spot on the roof where another heavy load is waiting. It's a large pile of plywood and lumber, weighing several hundred pounds, left over from previous work done on the roof. Larry's team has already prepped it for the lift with heavy canvas straps. While they hook the grapples to the lumber, Josh feels the cables brush over his back. Doug keeps a careful watch from above to make sure he's okay. Josh gets himself free from the cables and lets Doug know he's safe, so he can lift the load. And once the lumber is in the air, Doug and Jim turn the helicopter around and start heading back to the staging area, where they slowly lower this last load to the crew on the ground, who unhook the cables. With the three HVAC units in place and the lumber removed from the roof, today's job is completed and the helicopter lands back on the ground. The pilots make their way out so others can come inside because what comes next is a treat for a few friends and family members. A tour of this massive helicopter. It's the first time most have had a chance to go inside a helicopter, let alone one this big. When the fun is over, the crew packs up their gear, starts the engines, and runs through their safety checks to make sure all the functions of their helicopter are running smoothly. Then they close the hatch, lift up off the ground, and fly off to the next assignment. Now all that's left for Donovan Sheet Metal to do is give the HVAC units a final check, hook them up, and turn them on for a test run. Soon they'll be running smoothly, and the air inside the building will be nice and cool, even on the hottest summer days.